Hey guys, what?
Okay.
Sorry, entschuldigung.
No, ich muss just.
Hey guys, my name is Mike, and we're in Zermatt, Switzerland. There is the beautiful. Wow, that is way too bright. Right there is the Matterhorn. And today we're talking about my $100,000 crypto portfolio. Or rather, it was $100,000 up until the market crashed a little bit. It had a dip, a crash, as some people call it. Man, I lost $100,000. But today, it is going back up again. I'm extremely bullish about what's going to happen.
Lol.
I keep responding to comments on like Cardano, a little bit of IndiHash, a little bit of Ripple, this and that.
Okay, so I used my Ethereum to purchase some IndiHash tokens, and I also received a fair amount of IndiHash tokens for my participation in using sponsored videos with Barbara. So that is the largest amount of crypto that I have. I have nearly 123,000 tokens, and the tokens used to be worth 60 per share. However, that dropped a little bit. It's at 12 per share right now, and that's where most of my losses came from. However, that was due to the dumps. Now, they have a buyback program, and of course, as with any cryptocurrencies, you have to be in it for the long run. There's been some that absolutely failed at first, and they've been doing horribly. IndiHash was, I think, my biggest loss, but I'm not going personally against the company because most of this loss was not my money. It was rather a gift. It was just lost profit and an opportunity cost, which isn't that bad if you think about it. Hey, there's always risks within ICOs, and if you think about it, I could have made a lot of money had I sold. So some people sold, others didn't. I know people who have lost a couple hundred thousand on this, but I also know people who have lost a couple hundred thousand or even millions off of other investments such as Icon or VibeHub, where these were huge winners. There was a lot of winners where people became millionaires and people lost millions, and that's just how the markets go. Sometimes it's going up, sometimes it's going down, and if you are inexperienced or you decide to let your ego get in the way, that's where you will lose money. I admit I am certainly not the most experienced trader out there, but at least I have worked with the stock markets before. I'm making this video finally to address my personal, I guess how I lost $100,000, and it's kind of ironic how I started this off with, hey, here's my $100,000 portfolio, and then boom, wiped out. IndiHash at my maximum was worth $74,000 or $75,000 because I was approaching 124,000 of those tokens, which is a fair amount. That's about 0.1% of the entire circulation out there, or maybe it was even over that. I do believe it was just a little bit over. Anyways, so here is just a small little screenshot of what happened. As you just saw, it got decimated. What used to be worth $74,000, $75,000 in today's value would be worth less than $24,000, $75,000. Now, if you combine that with Steam, Ethereum, Bitcoin, Ripple, Cardano, pretty much everything dropping, we're the only one in its current state at $10.70. EOS would still be profitable for some of the purchases. Others, such as when I purchased at $12, wouldn't be profitable. But then again, it did go beyond $12. It's funny looking back at those videos. That's one thing. Oh my goodness. Switzerland was an amazing investment into my personal health. But apart from that, there was a lot of purchases that I do regret this year. I don't regret Switzerland. I definitely encourage a lot of you to go out there. It was nice, refreshing, and during that time, I wasn't really worried about the stress of the market collapsing. But today's video is a combination of those videos from February that I recorded.
Investing in ICOs isn't such a bad idea. You can make quite a bit of money. So first, let's chat about the normal alternative cryptocurrencies that I have, plus Bitcoin. Well, there you go, there's my first pick. How much Bitcoin do I have? Not too much, less than $500. I'm not somebody you should be taking investment advice from. You should just look at my opinion, take it with a grain of salt, think, okay, cool, and then do your own research based off of what I'm talking about. I have about $3,000 to $4,000 worth of Ethereum. I purchased a lot of altcoins with that. I invest into a lot of ERC-20 ICOs.
And today, where it's approaching July, so the markets have just recovered, I guess, a little bit. Bitcoin currently is 6,700, Ethereum's 538, and it was recovering from $480. So obviously, there was a lot of huge changes. Okay, so I've got Cardano. That was suspicious. So I had Cardano, Ripple, Ethereum towards the beginning of last year. The biggest two that have earned me the amount of profit that were able to set me off towards Steam later. And then I got super into it, started a crypto channel, was like, woohoo, ICOs, there we go. It was Ethereum and then Ripple. I was able to make three swings with Ripple before a fourth kind of got me down. I was like, oh man, well, I learned from my mistakes. Steemit had me earning quite a bit of profit. There was multiple ways to go through Steemit. I discussed it on both this channel, my other channel. I really enjoyed Cardano. I was a big fan of EOS. There was multiple times that I made great profits with EOS. Now we do understand that June, it wasn't the best handled coin, but it still held its ground at above $10. There was a time I invested in IOTA. I never got into Bitcoin Cash. I mean, okay, I had a little bit of it that I sold and that was that. Maybe a little bit of Litecoin here and there. I remember when I had Tron, it went up to, 18 cents. I was happy, then it fell back down again. I remember being happy with NEO and IOTA a little bit. There was some ICOs that I went fully into. The only one that I was quite upset with was BToken because that took a couple months later for me to get. And that also, so if I got it earlier, I'd have a couple thousand more. I'm not gonna go into the details, but out of the ICOs that are promoted, most of them were split between Ethereum or Bitcoin, mainly Ethereum, and then 50% of the tokens. And if you went with that deal, you earned 1.5 to 2 times the original amount after negotiations, and a lot of companies were A-okay with this. Then there was also Travel Block, which later off I sold my equity in for. And currently, I'm at a position where I'm gonna address this more in a future video, but I've got Vivid tokens where they're a couple thousand dollars worth, but they're not listed on any exchange, and it's not gonna get listed anytime soon, I guess. I have a teeny tiny amount of Bitcoin, less than 100. Steam, less than probably $1,500 total. Less than $250 worth of onions. But as I said, we're gonna go into details a little bit later. So what happened? The market went down. And my main regret, you try and live a life without regrets, but if we are to have any outcome from this video, is that I just didn't sell. Everybody was hodling, and hodling has definitely screwed over some people that weren't able to afford it. As in, I, for the most part of last year, was trading within bounds. And then once you start earning thousands and thousands of dollars at 19 years old, every week, and this is in a really easy format. It's just flowing in there, right? Some of these contracts, well, there wasn't any contracts with ICOs. People just send you money, and it was insane. You go from having $500 in your bank account at the beginning of the year, earning like $200 every month, to earning like $150,000 in a couple of months. Of course, you start thinking, well, I'm earning a couple hundred thousand dollars a year. It's not too far away from millionaire status. I mean, that's the next level. We gotta go for that. And everybody around you is either earning more than you, is giving you good advice, or at the time, maybe it was horrible advice, but they're like, yeah, we're gonna be millionaires. Do. People are buying Rolexes, BMWs, going on crazy 5-star luxury trips all around the world. And they're telling you all of this, and you're just surrounded by it. And these aren't people that is just like, oh, it's off in the distance. It's people you know. It's people you know in real life. You met at conferences, you met online, and then you're like, hey, what's up? Let's work, collaborate together. You see that, you get super inspired. I'm not gonna blame cryptocurrencies. I'm not gonna blame the government or the banks or my brother. I don't have a brother. I'm not gonna blame anybody but myself. And if you're blaming some third party figure, the Illuminati,
You need to own up, take responsibility. The greatest thing about losing $100,000, and by that I mean I actually lost more.
Within a week, I lost anywhere from $40,000 to $70,000. I can't pinpoint because I wasn't looking at the computer that time. I mean, you just don't want to look at the computer. When you're losing that kind of money, literally a BMW just flew out the window. In total, I'm thinking like, hey, I could have had a Maserati Quattroporte. I know it's a depreciating asset, but at least I'd have something, right? Here it's just boom, gone, nothing. These are hard life lessons that you learn from, and that's part of the reason why I wasn't uploading a lot. It's not even due to whether the markets are going up or down. It's more just you're ashamed and embarrassed of your own actions. But when you're young, you get to learn from it. When you're a little bit older, hey, it's time to kind of make sure everything, the bases are built. I don't have a family, I don't have kids, I don't have too many expenses. I live in an affordable place. So that's part of the luxury that I have that maybe others don't have, and that's why they're gonna be sleeping on the streets or currently are. Don't worry, I got a sleeping bag, I'm prepared. Are the markets going to turn around? Well, I'm still a firm believer in it. And as crazy as that may seem, okay, there's still a lot of money flowing around, hundreds of billions of dollars, and the jobs are coming in every single month. There's more and more companies. This isn't an industry that's just gonna go away. Maybe 90% of the coins aren't gonna be here next year, but the ones that really do stay, they're gonna matter. I mean, you look at if you invested in some of these companies 10 years ago, what the dividends in stocks would be. Google or Facebook or Microsoft, or there's a whole slew of them, Harley Davidson even. Well, crypto had its own little thing. My name is Mike Cabrera. Thanks so much for watching this video. I played too aggressively, that's what I got. I gotta live with my consequences. I learned you gotta set limits to yourself in terms of profit and in terms of the downsides. Hey, if you lose 10%, boom, sell everything. I could have sold everything while I was in Switzerland. Still had thousands and thousands of dollars just to blow around and do whatever I wanted, and I would have been fine. But hodling necessarily isn't the worst thing in the world if you can afford rent for the next year and you're paying your bills and you're not living a crazy expensive lifestyle. Where if you're doing that and you're losing, boo, those combined leads to you ripping all your hair out. Why do you think I got a haircut? Okie dokie, so we're the last people here. There we go.